Oh, 25 minutes past the hour now. Nadia Bilchik joining us for our morning passport. And yes, it's been years in Iraq, 9 years. That's a lot of stuff.
And a lot of money, a lot of money. Infrastructure, and around 505 military bases.
Yes.
So what the Americans did was give back most of the military bases, about 500 to Iraq. Half of those will become Iraqi military bases, but some of those bases have been auctioned off. And one that was auctioned off was Camp Buka, named after Fire Marshal Buka, in memory of Fire Marshal and his sacrifice and having died on 9/11 while rescuing people. So Camp Buka has been auctioned off, and it's both a hotel and a logistics center. So the idea is, instead of a doorman, you get a gunman, so you get a high-security hotel.
So the hotel is already there?
The hotel is already there. Now, it's more of a motel than a five-star hotel,
I
and I spoke to somebody who stayed there, and he said, well, it's not exactly luxury, but it's utilitarian, and for people who are involved in the oil industry, it's very, very useful. Now, what you're seeing is the proposal for plans. They would like to turn this into more of a center, a container storage oil for the oil industry, bearing in mind that this particular base is right near the oil fields. So oil and service companies are operating nearby. So that'll be their clientele.
So they auction it off again. All that money goes back to the Iraqi government?
All goes off to the Iraqi government. Look, it was below land value. Think about this. The Americans give the military bases back to the Iraqis. The Iraqis auction this off to Kufan, which is a construction company. They make use of the infrastructure. Yeah. You're seeing the plans. Think about electricity, all the infrastructure that goes into having generators. They're providing water for 5,000 people in the area. So it's a very good commercial use of the military base.
And what we're seeing here is really way down the road.
You're seeing way down the land. You're seeing what Kufan, a construction company, and the area is about the size of Disneyland. So you're seeing
what
they're proposing for this area, brilliantly located near the oil fields. So on a very positive level, what are we looking at? We're looking at from a war-torn country to a booming oil industry. On a negative front, you're saying, does a hotel have to be like a prison in order for you to stay there?
Another chapter is going to be written, but maybe this is positive. You look forward to some economic development there. Maybe this is something that could work. A lot of bases there.
And certainly a visionary, this particular construction company, to say, how can we make best use of the infrastructure that already exists?
Nadia Bilchik with our morning passport. There it is. Maybe we'll see this down the road. A grand opening. We'll go cover that one.
Yes, all right. That would be nice. The grand opening in Iraq.
Nadia, thank you as always.